Where are you watching this from? And how much has your world changed in the past few years? My world has changed a lot, mostly because of COVID-19. How many of you remember the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, when most of us had barely even heard about the new coronavirus and this unknown disease that it causes? Where did everybody turn to for answers? It wasn't the politicians, it was the scientists. And these people who spend most of their lives hidden away from the public eye, they were suddenly just thrown into the spotlight. And almost overnight, science became the lifeline of a world in despair. It was no longer this exclusive thing that was reserved for people in lab coats who used fancy instruments. You could overhear people in buses talking about the PCR tests and the antigens. Through this pandemic, it has become clear that science is a part of society. It holds a unique responsibility when it comes to solving many of the world's problems we're facing today. Science with Society. That's the name of our initiative. And although we started this a few years ago, the COVID-19 pandemic has made it even clearer just how important our mission is. We want to help improve the relationship between science and society. You might have noticed that in recent years, misinformation, conspiracy theories, and fake news, they have been spreading, and even more so during the pandemic. I truly believe that it's of vital importance that we as young scientists get active and we help bring science closer to society. There is a lot of brilliant research out there, from philosophy and sociology of science to the study of science communication. The issue is that other scientists often don't know about it. But before we talk about how we can do that, let me tell you a bit about who we are. I'll start with myself. My name is Shruti Mandhani. I grew up in Abu Dhabi, did my undergraduate in India, and I'm currently a research fellow in material science in the UK. I love my work, and it's probably why I enjoy telling people about it, even at a pub. PubHD is an event where PhD students or postdocs from any academic discipline explain their work to an audience at a pub in exchange for a pint. I got involved because I wanted to interact with the lay audience. For me, it was the perfect place to get feedback from an entirely different perspective. And of course, I got a free pint. But before I presented my work at a pub, I tried something a little bit more challenging. I entered a national competition called the 3-Minute Thesis. The challenge was to explain my entire PhD in exactly 3 minutes to a lay audience from varied backgrounds. And it was definitely as hard as it sounds. But also, it was a lot of fun, because the entire experience made me view my research from a completely different angle. 3MT is a global competition. Maybe there is one in your country. If so, I would highly recommend for you to take part. To my own surprise, I won the 3MT, and that opened up plenty of doors for me. One of them led me to the Trust in Science Working Group of the Global Young Academy. The Global Young Academy is an interdisciplinary global academy with members from all over the world that unites and gives a voice to young scientists from around the world. In the Trust in Science Working Group alone, there are people from around 20 different countries. During their discussions, the members of this working group realized that the relation between science and society, it's a global problem. Science with Society is a global initiative, and we hope to reach people from all over the world. When we're talking about science, it's not just about natural science or engineering, mathematics, and so on. Our concept of science includes social sciences and the humanities, because we believe we need them all to tackle the problems our societies are facing. Think about the COVID-19 pandemic. It didn't just affect our health. It affected our whole way of living, education, economics, the arts, everything. We need the natural sciences, the humanities, and the arts if we want to heal as a society from the aftermath of this pandemic and prepare for future disasters. And every scientist can help bring science closer to society. But we as young scientists, we're in a special position. We grew up with social media. We know how to communicate with the world on our fingertips. And so for us, it's much easier to level the playing field by being approachable to lay audiences. The younger you are, the better you can remember your experiences with being a beginner in your field. And that often makes it easier to form that connection with the lay audience. I truly believe that if more of us scientists engage in outreach, we can try and regain that trust in science. If people get to know you and your work, they will trust you more. And communicating something that you really love, like your research, it can be quite fun and also gratifying. Our video tutorials will show you some useful tools in building these skills and highlight the importance of developing them. We have two sets of video tutorials and quite a bit of bonus material. The first one is about ethics and scientific integrity, because we believe that it's crucial to critically reflect on our own responsibilities if we want to bring science closer to society. For the second set of videos, we have partnered with the German National Institute for Science Communication. You will learn from their experts how effective science communication works. So let's put together what belongs together: science with society.